Water efficiency is a technical problem we have because with technical measures, I think we can raise quite easily. From a political point of view, of course, we have to create a proper framework, especially in the sense of that we have a proper pricing system in place.
EIB has been looking at the implementation of the Water Framework Directive in the last 10 years. We see very much that it's not being implemented to its full potential.
In the UN Charter, water is a human right, it's a fundamental right. We need water like we need air to breathe. All ideas going in the direction that we raise water prices for drinking water, I think, are going in the wrong direction.
If the price for water is low, there is no drive for efficiency. And I think from one standpoint, I think we should increase the price of drinking water because that drives the need for reducing leakages and making sure that we definitely have the right quality of water.
We have to help households to pay for their, at the moment already, to pay for their water bills, to have proper access to drinking water, to have proper access as well to wastewater treatment.
I would urge, say, either say governments taking up the supply of drinking water just on their own and making sure that there is a cost benefit on the price of drinking water, so the inhabitants, the people in the country, should pay just the price of that water. If they do that, then there is also pressure on politicians and on governments to reduce that price, as price may increase due to leakages.
I would really advocate that we help people to save water, not to spend that much, and as well, of course, not to put so much water in the sewage system.
We are always talking about progressive pricing. So, for example, a minimum amount that people use, that people have the right to water, should be very cheap or very easily available for everybody. But if you go and water your garden or wash your cars or your golf course, that should then be priced with a higher price.
Every cubic meter of drinking water that can be saved is something that we need definitely in Europe. If you look to the pipe systems that we are using nowadays, which are very old sometimes, with say traditional materials, I think with the new materials we have available, we can reduce the leakage rate dramatically.
Efficiency of the infrastructure, for example, in agriculture should be increased, and also the savings that are achieved through increased efficiency are not used again, for example, for the enlargement of irrigation areas.
The infrastructure is at the moment on a European level mainly a financing problem because there are a lot of member states, and even in the rich member states, you see, to finance a proper water distribution system and a proper sewage system is a challenge.
Collecting rainwater and reusing that is something that we should do more and more. Rainwater falls out of the air. It's virtually clean, so why not using it and reusing it?
Taps and shower heads should be regulated on the European level because this could be done relatively easily and also deliver efficiency.
The question is if we should, from a European level, impose such efficiency standards. And having in mind that the situation, regionally speaking, and as well in the different sectors, is really totally different, I'm not sure if there is one-size-fits-all efficiency target for a member state, for a region, for an industry. So the red tape in comparison, in connection with that, is so huge that at the moment I do not see really a proper solution for that.